We are about to depart on our camping
journey.
It's gonna
to the far unknown of the wild.
So we're gonna basically
some dope.
Okay, you're spitting on me. All right, so we will be hiking
up the mountain of Marina Valley.
Like three
donkeys and
okay, we'll be hiking like maybe a 2-hour hike, and then we're just gonna camp out, set up a tent, and up in the mountains.
Yeah, sketchy.
We
yeah.
shall bring back a donkey's head.
All right, over and out.
What's up, guys? Starting off the trip with some gushers.
Oh my gosh.
So, see my finger? So we're starting out, we're gonna head right to there, and we're gonna go up. We might go beyond that point. Anyway, that's where we're going.
We are off on the start of this trail. No civilization in sight, except for a trailer and a playground.
There's Big Rock, and we're gonna be somewhere right about there.
But we're not at the top yet.
Nope,
almost, not quite. Like a half an hour, 45 minutes from the top.
Really? No, it's not.
No.
Really?
Yeah.
Maybe even 2 hours. And every gravel road is a trip down memory lane. And back home where the corn grows 10 feet tall. On a pantry wall, the willow trees are waving till we come back home again. So I'm saying goodbye to the skyline, hello to the sweet pines. Gonna see you later.
All right, so we made it inside the tent.
What a beautiful sunset, don't you agree?
Absolutely rootin' tootin'.
More gosh.
Yeah. Dark and gloomy. Tommy, they can't see you at all, but can you?
Oh, there's Robbie. Oh, you can see Robbie. Tommy, stand over here more light.
So, Tommy, tell us why in the daytime it's more windy than
the nighttime?
Yeah.
Well, in the daytime,
there's so many people
it's daylight saving. Oh. So, when it's daylight saving, there's less wind.
Wait, you're serious?
This is the first night of the camping trip. Things are getting sketchy. I saw a wild donkey and it charged me. But then I threw a rock and it went in the air and I struck the donkey. It's pretty epic.
So Tom, show us your staff of power that you are holding.
Yes, this is my beam of light that wards off dire wolves and Zubats.
Fun. Oh guys, that was a very very long, very
bad
long
night.
Me and Robbie were just sleeping on the bare floor with things over us, but Tommy got this, so.
Yeah, solid.
0.3 of an inch. Ready to go, guys?
Yes, I'm ready to go.
Not in a bad way.
Rob's holding up the whole dang group for one apple.
Rob, how important is your apple? Meanwhile,
did you not hear that?
I mean, I have my earbuds playing, so.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
Indeed. Robbie's.
This is a camping trip. No electronics. Except for the camera.
Good one, Tom. Robbie's apple. Here it goes.
For the donkeys. I did it for the donkeys.
Guys, we about halfway done, yeah?
Go!
See, this doesn't look like anything, but that's probably 30 feet. Kind of sketch. So we're going to do some cliff diving today.
Little bit of history lesson. The first person to discover Moreno Valley kind of walked up this rock, and then there's this huge crowd of people. He's like, "Look, Moreno Valley, they took us off the edge." And they called it Moreno Valley.
After his name?
And then, yeah, I get nicknamed Valley of Death.
Beautiful. Well, I've never heard that. Beautiful story, bro.
Wow, this is cool. This is cool. Back down the mountain to home ground, guys. They're still ahead of me.
Oh, shoot.
That rock. Okay. So there's that rock. Right there. Right there. And then we hiked up and to the right and behind that mountain. Pretty epic. So Tom, tell me, what was your favorite part of the camping trip?
Seeing the big rocks.
The big rocks?
Yeah.
Wow, what was your favorite part?
I don't know, looking at this. Probably eating.
Eating, that's always Robbie's answer.
Yeah.
My favorite part was pitching the tent and just chilling and watching the stars.
Eating was the best part.